Hello guys, so today I will be making ginataang tulingan. Bonita in Spanish, I guess. Aloy in Ilonggo. And I think this is one of the species or variety of tuna. So guys, here are the ingredients. I got like, you know, the spices. The onions, the ginger, garlic. And I got habanero pepper because I don't have the regular Filipino, you know, the one like the Filipino pepper, like, you know, the green and red one that we usually make. I cannot find that in the store. And I have mustard leaf here, like mostaza. I don't know, mustard leaves or mostaza, but this is called mostaza in Filipino. I have soy sauce and of course the salt and pepper and some pepper flakes. So I'm gonna layer this guys in the pot, and I will, like, you know, let's continue and we will cook it. Oh, hold on guys, I forget one thing. Hold on, just like what I said, I forget one thing. This is not cold ginataan without the gata, the coconut milk. So I will put everything in the pot and we will cook it. Okay, so this is how I do it guys. You know, the big stem of the mostaza leaves, I will put them first, you know, just like that. You know, the first layer would be the stem or the thicker part of the leaves of mostaza. And then next would be the fish. I didn't cut the fish because, you know, it's not that big enough and it fits in my pot. Just right there and like this. And then we will dump more stem from the mostaza, like that. Oh, you know what guys, I also forgot, we need vinegar as well. So while the fish is there inside our pot, we will now put the onions. Our habanero is right there. I will use all of it. The ginger and the onions, and we will put our soy sauce. And hold on guys, I will get the vinegar. So guys, I poured the vinegar on this little bowl right here where I put the soy sauce earlier, and this is probably like 1/4 cup. That's it. And then we will put some salt. Oh my god guys, I broke my, look. So here it is guys, I will pour the coconut milk and then we will start cooking it. So here I already turned the stove on and we will wait when it starts boiling. Okay, I still got some leftover, no, it's not actually leftover, but I still have some mustard leaves in here, which I'm gonna put this when our fish is already cooked. See guys how easy it is to cook ginataang tulingan. This is already cooked and I'm just waiting for it to dry it up. And just follow the instruction, it's very easy. And if you haven't subscribed to me yet, please subscribe and like this video. Thank you for watching. Bye.